The next factor affecting equilibrium constant is stoichiometry of the reaction. Stoichiometry of the reaction deals with the molar coefficients of the reactants and products as given in the balanced equation of the reaction. Let me illustrate it by some simple examples. The first thing is, suppose we are given a reaction like A plus B equal to C plus D. And at a constant temperature for this, equilibrium constant is equal to K. Then if I write the reaction as C plus D equal to A plus B, what's going to be its equilibrium constant? It's very simple to answer. For the first equation, K would be equal to C into D upon A into B, and for the second, it will be A into B upon C into D. Obviously, the equilibrium constant for the second reaction would be equal to 1 upon K. So if we reverse the equation as such, then equilibrium constant becomes inverse. The second thing is, suppose I have the reaction this one, N2 plus 3H2 equal to 2NH3. And for this, at some constant temperature, equilibrium constant is given as K. And if I write the equation as 1 by 2N2 plus 3 by 2H2 equal to NH3, all gases of course, then what's going to be the value of equilibrium constant now? It becomes surprising. The reaction chemically is the same. Nitrogen and hydrogen are combining to give us ammonia. But the value of equilibrium constant or the numerical value of equilibrium constant does depend upon how do we represent the reaction in the form of a chemical reaction. For this equation, it was K. And for this reaction or this equation, chemically reaction is the same. But for this equation, the value of equilibrium constant would be equal to under root K. It can be very simply proved for this reaction. K would be equal to concentration of ammonia or active mass of ammonia upon active mass of nitrogen raised to power 1 upon 2 into active mass of hydrogen raised to power 3 by 2. So this expression is nothing but equal to the square root of the previous expression. Therefore, we say that if the equation has been divided by 2, the new equilibrium constant is the square root of the previous one. We can generalize it. If I divide the equation by N, obviously, the new equilibrium constant would be nth root of the previous equilibrium constant. Similarly, if I multiply the given equation by 2 or any factor, say I write 2N2 plus 6H2 equal to 4NH3. See, I have multiplied this equation by 2. So what will be the value of equilibrium constant at the same temperature for this reaction, but represented by this equation? It would be equal to K square. So that if I multiply the equation by N, the new equilibrium constant will be raised to N. If I divide by N, the new equilibrium constant will be nth root of the previous equilibrium constant. One more thing regarding stoichiometry. That is, suppose we have a sequence of reactions like this. A changing into B. For that, equilibrium constant is equal to K1. Then I have another reaction, B changing into C, and for that, equilibrium constant is equal to K2. Then I have another reaction, C changing into D, and for that equilibrium constant is equal to K3, of course, at the same temperature. Now I want to know the equilibrium constant for a comprehensive reaction, that is A changing into D. As is clear on the board, this equation can be obtained by summing up all these three reactions. So what will be the equilibrium constant, the total equilibrium constant for this reaction? Its equilibrium constant will be product of individual equilibrium constants, and that would be equal to K1 into K2 into K3. So whenever we add some equations to get a new equation, the equilibrium constants are multiplied. Similarly, if I subtract one equation from another equation to get a third equation, then the new equilibrium constant will be equilibrium constant of the first equation divided by equilibrium constant of the second equation. It's again clear that if I write the equation as D changing into A, then the new equilibrium constant will be reciprocal or inverse of the equilibrium constant obtained over here. So mind it, whenever equations are to be added, equilibrium constants are to be multiplied. When they are to be subtracted, equilibrium constants are to be divided. So that's all about the stoichiometry of the reaction. How does it affect the equilibrium constant that we have seen? The third factor affecting equilibrium constant is standard free energy change. We represent this change by symbol delta G naught. I have already introduced to you a symbol like delta G. We have noted it that at equilibrium delta G is equal to zero for every reversible reaction. Then what is delta G naught? We call delta G naught as standard free energy change. It means change in the free energy of the reaction when things are taken in the standard state. So let me clarify, what do we mean by a standard state? Also, such things will be dealt in detail in the chapter of thermodynamics. But for the time being, you should know, what do we mean by a standard state? Standard state for any substance means its concentration should be unity. It's 1 mole per liter. Then, if the substance is in the gaseous state, its standard state means its pressure should be unity. It should be 1 atmosphere or 1 bar, as the case may be. So, when things are taken in the standard state, the change in the free energy is called delta G naught. This delta G naught is related to the equilibrium constant by a formula. Delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303 RT log of K, where K is equilibrium constant for the reaction. It's very clear from this equation that if equilibrium constant is in the form of Kc, the numerical value of delta G would be differing for the reaction whose Kp is numerically different from Kc. There are reactions, as we are going to see just now, that if Kc and Kp are numerically equal, delta G naught would be same for the reaction. But if Kc and Kp are numerically different for the same reaction, the reaction will have two different numerical values for delta G naught. So, if we know equilibrium constant, we can calculate delta G naught. We know delta G naught, we can calculate the value of equilibrium constant. Here again, there is a point of caution, that is, what value of R you will substitute while doing some mathematical calculation? The value of R, as I already told you, is 2 calories. It's also 0.0821 liter atmosphere. It is 8.314 joules also. Which value will be substituting over here? It all depends upon the unit in which delta G naught is expressed. Delta G naught cannot be expressed in terms of liter atmosphere. It can be expressed in terms of energy unit like calories or joules. So you will have to substitute R either in terms of calories or in terms of joules depending upon the unit of delta G naught. Temperature is of course the Kelvin temperature of equilibrium, and the numerical value of equilibrium constant can be calculated with its help. It's again clear from this equation that if delta G naught for a reaction is a negative quantity, delta G is negative, then what would happen? Then equilibrium constant for that reaction is bound to be more than 1. And if delta G naught is a positive quantity, then K is bound to be less than 1. However, if delta G naught is equal to 0, then K would be equal to 1. Don't forget, the value of delta G is bound to be 0.